Wu-Tang and American Saga, really great and entertaining show. Join us as we separate the fact from the fiction. Peace, family. This is Uncle Reem, and welcome to Uncle Reem's Reactions. Today, we're here to react to Wu-Tang and American Saga Season 1. My reaction won't be what we're accustomed to seeing in YouTube reactions to shows. I have a real affinity for Wu-Tang. I'm a lifelong fan, or rather, I've been a fan ever since high school. So my reaction will be more so not to each episode, but to many of the things that take place in the show. Some of it is real and some of it is embellished. And it's already been stated by members of the group, other individuals who are associated with the group, that, you know, all of the events that occur in the show aren't necessarily 100% accurate. There's a lot of, you know, sometimes when you have a show, you know, when a show reaches the screen, a lot of times there's a lot of modifications that need to get done, a lot of shifts in time and things of that nature. To tell a story is more difficult to fit everything in. So they had to take certain liberties. They had to use certain poetic license. And so my reaction would be to do the research and to separate what's real and what's fake, because a lot of viewers do have those questions. Before we get started, first let me just say, I need everybody to, if you have not done so already, like, comment, share, and subscribe. And let's get into it. So the format that I will use today in moving forward in the other parts of this that we're going to do, because it's so much information that we won't be able to settle this in just one episode or one part, or we'll have to separate it in multiple parts. So the way that this is going to be formatted, though, is just in common questions that people have about the show. For instance, the first question we'll start off with, and I'll try to go in order based on how it occurred in the show. I don't want to get too detailed into events because I don't want to put a lot of spoilers for people who have not yet seen it. There will definitely be some spoilers, so for all of those who have never watched the show, just know that there may be some spoilers. I'm taking care to avoid many spoilers, but there will definitely be some because we can't really discuss it in depth, without there being some spoilers. So the first question: were Raekwon and Ghostface Killah really beefing? So this question is a little bit complicated because based on the interviews with individuals in Wu-Tang and individuals associated with Wu-Tang, the question may vary depending upon who you ask. However, a majority of individuals in Wu-Tang outside of Raekwon and Ghostface Killah have confirmed that their beef was factual. However, so what we'll do is we'll look at some of the people who've commented on it. So there's an interview with Papa Wu on Doggy Diamonds. Doggy Diamonds is, he's a content creator for YouTube. I think he's a podcaster as well. And he had an interview with Papa Wu. For those who don't know who Papa Wu is, Papa Wu, he passed away recently. Rest in peace. But he's a member of the Nation of Gods and Earths. Some people consider him the 5% nation. But he's one of the elders, you know, one of the elder mentors, spiritual advisors to members of the Wu-Tang Clan. He's an older cousin of old Dirty Bastard. You know, he's from Brooklyn, but he stated that he's lived in Staten Island previously before. He's known all of the Wu-Tang members. He's watched a lot of them grow up as youth. If you listen to Wu-Tang's music on a lot of songs, you can hear his voice, you know, him dropping jewels and giving gems. Some examples are on Wu-Tang's album, Wu-Tang Forever. He's on the first song called Wu Revolution, which is really just a RZA beat with Papa Wu and other other old elder members of the Nation of Gods and Earth dropping lessons out of the 120 lessons, which the Nation of Islam called the Supreme Wisdom Lessons. You will also hear him on Ghostface album on a few songs. He's on a song called Black Jesus. He's at the beginning of the song Black Jesus before the song starts. And he's also on the song with All That I Got Is You, which is the Ghostface with the Mary J. Blige feature. You can pretty much hear Papa Wu throughout a lot of the Wu catalog. However, he stated that, and this is prior to Wu-Tang and American Saga. He made this statement in the interview prior to Wu-Tang American Saga even happening. He stated that Ghostface and Raekwon used to shoot at each other. This is what Papa Wu said. Capadonna was recently asked that question in the interview. I can't really readily remember the interview, but I will definitely look it up and post it. But he recently said it in an interview that, when he got out of prison and he saw Raekwon and Ghostface together, he was kind of surprised at that because of the beef they had previously, and he never would have thought that they would, that they would be working together. So he definitely suggested that, outright stated that Raekwon and Ghostface did have beef. And there's another interview with the RZA where he outright states that Raekwon and Ghostface Killah were mortal enemies. This is what he said. This is out of the RZA's mouth. Raekwon and Ghostface Killah were mortal enemies before they came together as a part of Wu-Tang Clan. On The Breakfast Club, Charlamagne Tha God questioned Raekwon about it. And Raekwon pretty much stated that they were part of crews that had beef with each other. And there were certain individuals from within their crew that had, serious beef with one another. But them individually, it didn't play out the way that it played out on the show. I don't think he definitively stated that they never got at each other, period. But he did state that the way that it happened in the show, that's not the way that it played out in real life. And Ghostface, when he was questioned about it in an interview, he said something similar to what Raekwon said. So, just looking at all of the different stories and looking at all of the different Wu members who made points about it. And I think there was even an interview, with Inspector Deck on You're Not A Mean Cop podcast, which is a podcast with Laura Jamar and Rod Digger. And he stated, he talked about the parts of the show that are false or that have been embellished. And I believe that the Raekwon Ghostface situation was one of the situations that he brought up. I don't think he went into depth about it. But so there's considering the differing assertions of the different clan members, I would just state that I think that they had, that their crews had beef, that there was a beef between the two, enough that there would have been tension between the two. Did they shoot at each other? Maybe, is the G-code. If that did happen, they probably, it's something that they want to keep behind them, so they don't want to maybe outright state it. But definitely, based on all of the statements that's been said, there was definitely some tension and some beef there between Raekwon and Ghostface. So, the next question. Was Seventh Chamber, which is a song that's on Wu-Tang's first album, Enter the Wu-Tang 36 Chambers, was that the first song that Wu-Tang recorded that ended up on their album? Because on the show, Wu-Tang and American Saga, after the situation occurs with Raekwon in regards to Ghostface's, home, I won't elaborate, but he stopped by RZA's home and did whatever he did, but the result of his visit to RZA's home was him laying down his verse to Seventh Chamber. And, you know, that verse, champion your gear that I rock, and get your boots knocked, then attack you like a pit, then lock shit down. That verse. So, my question is, if that were the first verse, or rather, you know, the one of the first songs that Wu-Tang made, or rather they made it prior to them being Wu-Tang, because at this stage in the show, they hadn't even become Wu-Tang yet. In fact, RZA hadn't even become Prince Rakim yet. So this is early in their story. You know, Sha Raider hadn't become Raekwon yet. D-Lover, Dennis Coles hadn't become Ghostface yet. Neither one of them had become who they would later be in terms of their personas in music. So if that were a song that eventually became, that made Into the Wu-Tang 36 Chambers, I wonder how Raekwon was able to make Wu-Tang references in that song. For instance, when he says, "Nah, sure to get you open like six packs, killer bees attack." Killer bees, that's one of the nicknames, if you will, that the Wu-Tang collective use to describe themselves. Killer bees, Wu-Tang, killer bees, we on the swarm. So he makes a reference to killer bees, which is another like name that Wu-Tang refers to themselves as. Something else that Raekwon said was, "Hey, yo, bomb it. We usually take off niggas' garments." Now, "we usually take all niggas' garments." That's a backronym, which is an acronym that is, you know, looked back on and applied to a word. For instance, Wu-Tang has the letters W-U-T-A-N-G. If we look at "we usually take all niggas' garments," we'll see the letters of Wu-Tang is the first letter of each of those words. So he's essentially spelling out Wu-Tang. How would he have come to that position if the group were already formed? So that was something in a, you know, in a, and I believe that was in the first episode when that was happening. And that was just something that immediately stood out to me, that if they're not Wu-Tang yet, how was Raekwon able to have such foresight? Okay, so that's it for part one of, you know, separating fact from fiction, Wu-Tang and American Saga. Stay tuned for part two. We'll definitely do multiple parts of this. We'll try to narrow down questions out of the whole series, and you know, from there we'll try to answer some questions. The link will be in the description of any facts to support what I'm stating here. So that you can go back and you can do the research yourself, that I'm not just sitting here stating something that I haven't researched myself or that I haven't seen in the interview and so forth. So I will definitely put the link in the description. So thank you for listening. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Peace, I'm out.